Renewed communication. I suppose I have some experience in this field because I work remotely with different companies now. I think I can put around 5 years. And during this time, I also created and did a personal research during 8 months, just acquiring information data to see what sets apart the successful remote companies in the world compared to the others. And without further delays, I want to tell you that the number one tool in a remote environment, work environment, when it comes to communication is over communication. Ask any successful remote company, it will tell you that this is not only crucial, but it's a must-have tool since day one. When it comes to communication, everything is already subjective, so we have tons of errors just to move on with our normalcy bias, which is one of the most frequent cognitive errors from my first episode. In communication, we have tons of errors. And so if you write an email or a message, you need to consider that everything will be biased from your recipient according to how she or he woke up that day, what happened around, and now if you are also blocked at your home and with your kids and with your family, these things can be even more sensitive. So if you have a company which was forced now to move into the remote environment or just trained and start from scratch a team in this kind of remote setting, you need to know that in communication, first filter, it will be the make sense filter. In a remote setting, if you don't understand what the other person said, you will try to make sense, especially if it involves your job. Of course, so you will make sense of that information, and if it's not clear enough, you will give it your specific, completely subjective sense, and then you will transform it in a story form, and then that information will reach your conscious mind. So just imagine what kind of errors can happen in every kind of setting with this type of very short form of communication. You can create a mayhem in your company. That is why I am saying that you need to consider this and be very, very specific. So a successful remote company uses a lot of tools, and we don't talk now about this because if you're just starting and you don't have a lot of budgeting, maybe you will just start with the Google Suite, which provides you pretty much everything just to get a feel of it. You also have the Hangout. You can have conferences, video conferences, chat and everything. If you are going overboard a little bit and you're more extensive as a company and you want better tools, you can move to the project management softwares and platforms like Basecamp and Trello. I favor Basecamp. Or you go to the CRM systems, HubSpot, Salesforce, and others. In communication, you do have Slack. And of course, now with video, you also have Zoom. Some companies still use Skype for some reason. And now you can have all these platforms and you can acquire them and start using them pretty quickly. But if you use them wrongly, then everything just goes to hell. So you need to know in communication to over-communicate, to write a lot more than you intended at first. And also just think like to a kid who learns everything from scratch. So just write things there very specifically, very clearly. For example, in communication, WordPress does a great job. They have a system, their personal platform, where you can pretty much find any kind of information and just go back to the beginnings. And so if you are a newbie in that company, you just need to stay in their platform and study a little bit, and you will find everything you need to know about your job without interpretation, or without so much interpretations like if you don't use over communication. So just be specific, like talking to a child every time, because this can cost you a lot of money if you do it wrong, or you think, presume that the other person understands what you want to say. No, it won't. Everything will be subjective according to its own mindset and that state it's in that moment. Because we are all emotional creatures, we are more emotional creatures than cognitive creatures, rational creatures. So you need to take this in consideration. And now the final part, which I want to address to leaders, is that if you are a leader now in such an environment, you need to set an example. People are scared. They are truly scared, even if they don't show this. And if it's for the first time when they are in a remote setting, whew, their level of anxiety is very huge. So you as a leader should be on a camera. This time it's not enough just to write. Like, you see, I'm also on the camera because I know this kind of personal communication is more important in these days, like never before. So you as a leader, put yourself on a camera, even if you don't like it, it's because it's for your people. And if you can do this on a daily basis, this is very important. It's not enough once a week. Now, frequency counts also, because during 24 hours with all the news and all the changes, you don't know what happens in your employee's mind, and this anxiety level can grow. And if doesn't have a contact from a leader who they trust, they will start developing other kind of frustration and stress levels. This will also have an effect on their performance and crucial kind of tasks. You need to consider that now you are a mother and a father and the light at the end of the tunnel. So be there as a leader, put yourself on a camera and get in touch with your employees wherever they are. Ask what they are doing. Do Zoom calls in the morning or just send them little video messages. Create a platform of communication where your teams can see each other on a daily basis and have this kind of therapy group session. Doesn't need to be called like this, but they just need to have debriefing, like at least 10 minutes a day or 30 minutes or 1 hour to get used and see their colleagues, because now you do have the tools to just adjust this kind of remote setting. But do it and don't just hide from the camera. These are new times, we all need to adjust this. And if you're a leader, then use over communication and be there for your people on the camera. See you next time!